And what a month it would be, because apart from winning that UK Open, took everybody apart at Hayland Island, some big scalps there, to win this. What a month that would be for the man.
Absolutely. Lovely first start here. Well.
Yes, 170! Oh, that'll hit part in the solar plexus.
Second leg, he's Raymond to throw first. Game on.
What a shot.
Absolutely fantastic finish there from Barneveld.
100.
What an amazing shot by Barney. Maybe the mood's changed. Maybe he's feeling that he can give a touch of Barneyitis to the Canadian.
Well, threaten the big checkout from time to time. And you know, the feature of Barney during this tournament, and indeed we saw it in the Premier League, is his propensity for hitting the really big checkout when he has to, Sid. A 130 earlier this week, a 150 earlier this week, and that 148 against Phil Taylor yesterday at a vital time. And that 170 against the throw there could put him in contention now, could take him on his way to winning this set.
And the facial expression conveys the different mood. He too is wincing with effort, like part is. Could be a classic, this one. An echo in that sort of thing that John just said in the league. Wanted 5-ton-plus finishes in the match at Sunderland.
66.
So, as John says, exact point. He's just the lad for 120, 130 shots and higher out of the locker. And a few maximums, too.
Well, the previous highest checkout to that in this match was that 115 from Part in the third set. If you remember, he went into 20 when he was going for bull, and then it treble 19, double 19. 170 is not going to be beaten, that's for sure. And Barneveld will be here for 92, treble 20, double 16, 87 left. He'll come down for treble 17, 70 left. Treble 18 leaves double 8. He's got plenty of time, 52 left.
First of six sets is the winner. Desert Classic title holder. Barney averaging 97.5 to John's 92.5. And as John Quinn said, signs that Barney's cranking up 52. To peak power. Double 16. Oh, Milo, we're bad shot.
20.
Well, Part will regret the fact that he hasn't pressurized and got a little bit closer. So, everybody here, as well as in Coventry, will be wondering if Barneveld takes this set. Which way is it going to go from three sets all? There it is, two legs up now in this set. And on his way, surely to taking it, though Part has fought back many a time before.
Ominous for John Part that Barney has just pushed his average up to his tournament average. He's sitting on 97 now to John's 92. That's a different mood. The Dutchman putting in the clog when it matters.
100.
There you see it, and a good 4 points, almost 3.5 anyway, difference between the two. Not reflected in the score. Because it's not always the case. Part has won his sets less comfortably than when Barneveld has won his. That's impressive, Sid, got to say. And yet, you sense that they haven't been at their brilliant best on the doubles, but that's pretty impressive.
I want to beat Bobby George in that final. It was 66% checkouts. That's 100. Pretty good. Well, we have seen 69 here this week.
Yes, and Part for a long time in one match was 70-ish. Yes, you're right.
140.
Probably at the double first. Lovely, lovely weight. He's feeling the weight of the door. Oh, he's feeling the weight of the dart beautifully, especially to the 60s, John Part.
Not to keep this set alive, but Barney knows he's up first, next leg.
90.
And he won't have given this up if Part misses tops. Barneveld will be there with 1-1-1, but he's not missed the tops. Stays in the set.
John Part. Fourth leg, it's Raymond to throw first.
Well, events in the last 6 months really focused on this man in darts as he joined the PDC in the Premier Darts League. Holiday makers here and fans. We talking to American matrons, me and John Quinn last night. I said, we're here for dark. What about you? He said, yes.
121.
Yeah, come all the way from California. Not a million miles away.
97.
Barney should be favorite. It's a lovely overall score to 3 at decent sets. Oh, slack dart. That really lost the weight of the dart there.
60.
Yes, and then we're searching then for the treble that was never there, was it?
Good word, that's a good way to express that loss of the momentum.
60.
And this is reminiscent of one of the legs earlier in the match where they went 12 darts, these two, between them without hitting a treble. And then suddenly the 13th dart from Part went in, and this is similar, and how?
Oh. 140.
The tendency is with that shot, John, is to lose your balance slightly as you're trying to drive the dart under the marker.
140.
So sometimes the third dart goes low if the lie is low in the bed.
So 180 make a hole in this, but that's not the start he wanted. Oh dear, disappointing from Part's point of view, this.
Well ahead on the top 40s and turn plus scoring.
Raymond, you require
Barney.
161.
Just missed a 60. Here we go then,
95.
John Part to try and snitch closer in this final sixth set.
Well, he's throwing first. He knows how important this is because he's throwing first in the next leg and he could go 4-2 up. Double 16. What a dart in this match. Oh,
96.
If that had gone in, two legs all, throwing
66.
First for the set. What a difference that could make.
10. 20 and double 18 is usually his old favourite for the set. On the
30.
Wire!
Well, Barney could rue
John
that. He was given the
16.
Opportunity by the missed dart at double 16. Double 8 it is now then for Part. This has been kind to him during this match. He's come back from two legs down to level up and he's throwing first now. Is there going to be a two-set difference, Sid?
Game on.
But again, we called him, the word we used is pivotal. Fulcrumatic, whatever you like. This is where the gap could appear or the gap could disappear. Hence the sneer on the face of Part. Lovely dart.
He's got the bit between his Canadian teeth right now.
The red bit.
And occasionally the green bit 16. Down below. Yes, this looks like being a big, big set. Barney, two legs up and now fighting to hang on in there.
See, folks, sometimes no need for big adjectives when big'll do. Not quite the smooth dart.
95.
Maybe not enough. You'd expect John Part to have darted a double for 4-2.
Yes, sometimes the delivery of a dart can lack conviction.
94.
And it's usually a sign that a player is under a little bit of pressure, and Barney is right now. Definitely, we saw him take out 170 at the beginning of this set. Now can Part end the set with the same?
Psychological blow this would be. 60. Oh, lost the line. Ooh, needs the big treble, or Barney can snip back in. Oh, no big treble. No big treble. Turn 40 means this will get even tighter. Just the lad to do it as well, Barney. Oh, magic! All a lot, maybe. Oh, what a time to plunder Max! Game on!
Yeah, you've got to say that was sheer class. And it means now that Barney might well rescue something. After all, that's the best 180 he's hit in this match, Sid.
Raymond, you require
with you, Johnny,
66.
For a level match. Single 15. 2 16s for a level match. On the way!
This leg is pivotal. It
Johnny
really is. It could determine
68.
The direction in which this championship is going to go. If Part wins the set, he's 4-2 up. Now 16 for double 16. He wants tops here instead. Went for that deliberately, I feel. Oh,
just on the wire! Face says it all! Would have
32.
Made it 4-2, but to take it to level for Devils. Barney's got three in his hand and all he wants is the green bit. He's making life difficult for himself. No! We have parity! Bonneville, three sets. John Part, three sets.
It's Raymond to throw first. Game on.
Yes, and he's broken back. He's broken back the set, the third set that Part took from him. He's broken it back now. And as you say, parity, three apiece. And here we are, set by set. You can see that wonderful third set there from John Part. He lifted his game enormously there, and he's maintained a decent standard ever since. Barney's been pretty well the same all the way through, as we'll see now. Not hardly deviated. Barney's best there, obviously, the fifth.
Absolutely. 100.8, then 99 to Barney in the fifth. Standard is increasing. They are both sitting in the mid-90s. There will be glitches. It could maybe depend on glitches, this. First man of six, the winner.
Just to recap there, Part is sitting on 127. Barney on 246, Sid, and he plants in a 180 that was absolutely magic, and it set him up for that. And although they were a bit long-winded about hitting the double in the end,
140
because
well, they're both sweating like desert donkeys now.
140.
First man of six, the winner. Lovely, lovely dart. Lovely dart. 25's handy. Oh, yes!
45.
Played on cuts now, atomistic darts. 22-18, Israeli misses. Oh!
30.
But that has been a feature of his game today. The double that rarely lets him down has been evasive. No doubt about it. This is Part's favourite double too. And it's there. It's there. He got it in.
Jump on.
Double two. I don't mean double two. I mean double as well. You know what I mean. But illustrated there perfectly that both of them like the double 18, but Part's the one who's hitting it.
Well, earlier in the week, John Part split his pants up there and he borrowed a set of Barney's pants. They are both going to have to get the pants to the laundry here because they'll be soaked in sweat. What a match. What a match.
Yes, there we are. That's a fifth 180 to Barneveld. And in fact, he hit two in the first set. Then we didn't see one from him until the last leg of the fourth set. Number seven for Part.
Double 18. He's 0 for 6. And Bart is 3 from 4 on 18s.
So Barneveld has had 6 attempts at double 18 and he's not hit it once. That's a phenomenal record, really, for a man who's so, so good at it normally. It can happen, though. All dart players know that.
Well, Part is striding that hockey like a feral iguana.
95.
He's playing on adrenaline. He is really prowling now. Trouble 19, maybe? Yeah. Double 12 to go further apart. Oh, yes, that's it! This is good! With a capital G, U, T! This is the John Part that took Taylor in the world final.
Well, he's found himself, hasn't he? He's found his form, Part. It's taken him the course of this week. He's battled his way through to the final. And now, having come from two sets down yesterday against Wes Newton to play in this final, he took a little while to get going, but we're seeing the John Part of all for certain. And an 8-180 to the Canadian.
He is absolutely steaming here. Barney is making slight misses. But this is an incredible purple patch. Lost in the final to Manly 16-12 in our second Desert Classic.
Yes, that's right. And that was the year, of course, when he was world champion and the reigning world champion at the time. And Peter Manley threw exceptionally well in that final. It was Part who went into it as favourite.
Right. A great chance now for Part to set up the win of set seven. He looks like a man raked with pressure and tension, but he's throwing beautiful.
He is. He's throwing superbly.
95.
Well, he's left 167, so we know that Barneveld will give it a go if he gets a chance. Tops for then for Part for the set. Sets it up.
Gets it. Part. Reeling back the years to when he took out Till in 2003 in the World Championship. Absolute bedlam here. Barney looks dejected, but there's a way to go, folks. Part needs pottery.
European Open in association with the Royal Bank of Scotland, Thursday, 10 a.m. Sky Sports 1. These are Europe's achievers. And with less than 3 months to the Ryder Cup here at the K Club, they'll want to impress. But any golfer will tell you it's tough getting to the top. And when you do, you too could be one of the world's major achievers. Look and learn as the great masters of the game also compete this Thursday in the US Senior Open, 7 p.m. Sky Sports 2.
Get your skates on because Citroën prices are frozen this month. A roomy Berlingo Multispace from just $7,995. Or the Zara Picasso from just $8,995. A C4 that's alive with technology from just $9,195. And on selected Berlingo, Zara Picasso and C4 models, typical 0% APR with 35% deposit. Cool Citroën deals save up to $4,645 this month.
Sets it past one, sets it past two, flips it up. Oh, what a goal! Shh! Steve Inyo, looking for his second, takes it on his chest. Oh, he's gone into the samba, the crowd, oh, they're loving it. And now, he's on his hat-trick. He turns, he shoots. No! Oh! Headed off the line.
If you're buying a car, you want to get the most for your money. Call the AA and you could get a low rate of just 6.2% APR typical. And with plenty of low repayment options, you can choose a monthly amount to suit your budget. So with the AA, you could afford an even better car than you thought. For a decision in minutes, call 0800 234 6000. That's 0800 234 6000 or visit theaa.com. Call now and you could also get a free 6-month AA car warranty.
Today, we're searching for even cheaper car insurance. We all know it's a real jungle out there. It doesn't have to be. Elephant.co.uk specialises in cheaper car insurance on the internet. You can go online, get a quote in minutes, you could save loads. So, to see how much you could save, go straight to elephant.co.uk.
For even cheaper car insurance, it's elephant.co.uk.
I'll tell you what, it's showtime here. We're witnessing an absolute belter here. When they talk about ding-dongers, this is one that's really ringing. It's one way and then the other, and it's Part at the moment who's ahead 4-3. And with the advantage of the darts in this set, he's just broken Barneveld by taking a set 3-0. And look very, very impressive, Sid. And certainly look for the more likely winner.
Absolutely. Barney had a ding-dang-do. As the man says, Bilton, UK Open champion. But John Part is looking every inch the classic player. He'll be tailing the 2003 World Championship. First man is six, is the winner. Ooh, slack last dart by Barney Standards. He's got five 180s to John Part's eight. In that classic last night against Taylor, there were 23 180s.
83.
First set to Barneveld, 3-1. Second set to Part, 3-2. Third set to Part, 3-2. Fourth set to Part, 3-2. Fifth set to Barneveld 3-2. Sixth set to Barneveld 3-2. And 3-0 a moment ago. There the averages. There's not that much between them now, Sid. There was a bit of a gap earlier, not so long ago, and Part has closed it.
100.
That checkout difference is, as I said, 66% when he took Bobby George in the Embassy final. So yes, Gur, anything over 60 is brilliant. 55 is 95. Very good.
41 is acceptable, but only when the other fella's got an average of a percentage rather of say third of less than that. When you're playing against a man who's with a 55, you've got to be there yourself, as Phil Taylor himself would know, and probably rue the fact that he missed a double or two himself yesterday.
4-3.
Favourite John Part, race to six.
John, you require
should be at the double first. Could in fact hit the double with this visit. Showing the tension now around the gills.
63. Raymond, you require 58.
So Topsy wants to take the first leg against the throw. He knows how important it is, and they're not going in. The shake of the head says it all. 80.
Is it ever? Sleek with sweat. Lovely first dart. Two tens, go ahead. Oh, it'll be four legs on the trot if this goes in. Double five.
Oh, he hit a massive double five earlier in the contest when he really needed it. And well done there to John Part. He's holding himself together extremely well, Sid.
Bonnie's trying to relax.
100.
Nice last dart. But for my money, he's feeling the weight of the board better. As Part throws the dart much harder than Bonnie. Slack was in that, John.
Yeah, they're not going to, all of them are not going to go in, are they? And this is where Barney might capitalise. Probably doesn't like the lie of that, though. I don't know why. It looks all right to me, and that's it. 6-180.
With a casual elegance, got him named Matt Van the Man. Pleased to see an article today about Barney's rise in the English Observer newspaper. We've had facts to us.
59.
Nice to see the posh paper taking interest in the game. But it has been the story, John, hasn't it, the last 6 months? It's been Barney 6 months.
Absolutely fantastic. And the nice thing as well, Sid, is that he is so pleased with the way things have gone since his move. He has no regrets whatsoever, feels totally at home, and says he's in Britain now more than he normally would be. He's travelling the world more than he did, and has no regrets 60. At all, and he's really enjoying his darts as much as he ever has done.
And his wife says they're eating Stilton as well as Gouda now. Here we go then. Barney surely will clip out here. But Johnny's got other ideas. What an amazing! Could have got another 9 yards in that bed. Barney wants 2 fours.
Well, he's got 2 fours. That was one of those 180s from Part that just keeps his game going. It wasn't a vital one, and nevertheless, it proves that he's still hitting the target when he wants to. Here we go, look. Thought there was room there for plenty more.
89.
Ding-dong battle here. Twice world champion John Part taking on 4 times world champion Ray Barneveld in this last Vegas desert. Classic, and I mean classic with a capital K.
There's
terrific John 40 there. And again, a full house here in the Mandalay Bay, Sid. It's here in Clark County. It's voting day today, voting for the sheriff, I noticed. But they haven't cast theirs yet. They're waiting till this match is over. Then they'll go put their X on somebody's.
What an amazing shot. Part setting up an 11 darter, possibly. It is an absolute blinder.
60. John, you require 92.
For the lead in the eighth set. Barney now. Barney, 60. What's the bets? Even money that he gets a one in here?
Well, certainly. Similar to last leg, you remember that part hit one, didn't he, when he didn't really need it, so...
95. When even the qualifiers 4 days ago were getting 11 darters, you knew this kind of thing would happen. 216s. Will he use the barrel, or will he just dip the shot low? Oh, he's got it all to do. Houdini shot, wiggle. No oh, he hit the barrel of the middle dart.
And he's given Barneveld the sort of chance that he's been taking this week. When he's really needed these, he's been taking them out. Can't now, though. Can't now. So we'll see Part back for 2-1 in this eighth 65. Set.
Johnny required 32.
Double 16 to go into pole position. Half an inch adjustment to two hits. Open end of the bed, using the... Oh, brilliant, brilliant! Use the lion bed on the way as the marker!
Can't remember John Part missing double eight in this match. Thought he might there, but it's been pretty good. That's very sound. Very sound indeed. Barneveld got to hold his throw here and then try and break the fifth leg in order to level up again.
Here we go then, Part. Can go one set away from victory. He keeps them there. Brilliant darts. The armchair style, the 60. Fluency against the much more tense, aggressive style of the Canadian. It's a ruckus. It's a fast match. Like when Johnny did Alan Evans.
Well, Barney hasn't been ahead in this match since the first leg of the third set. He won the first set, was pegged back in a second set where every leg went with throw.
Right, here we go. Part favourite for 5-3. Favourite for 5-3. He will not miss, I predict, the treble with his visits. Whoa, he is on fire, Johnny. On fire.
Didn't expect anything else. He's a true pro, brilliant player. And whilst it took him a little while to get going, John Part, he's certainly not going to let this one go. It's got to be Barneveld who's got to raise his game to get back in it, Sid, because Part won't let him in.
Bogey number here, though. He's going to set up a nice little single poke at a double. Bull handy.
105.
Well, he's 57 left. That's nice. 17 tops when he comes to the hockey again. Barney can... make sure that it's pressurised a little bit.
105.
That'll leave him 120. 17 and tops then.
17 to go one set away for the match tops. Badly, badly pulled two tens will do.
47.
Well, oddly enough, today John Part has good old blues. Yes, I like Sidney myself. John Part has hardly hit double top, you know. The double top has been not kind to him. And it's not the first time he's gone for double five in this match. Got it a few legs ago. Got a vital one earlier in the match. Needs double five here.
For 5-3. Oh, this has to be an incredible shot because he's going to take the flight into consideration as well as the barrel. The flight's still a bother for 5-3.
Five score.
And he'll ruin that. Now, Barneveld has left himself here a three-dart finish. That's one saving grace. He's got to get treble 20 now for double 16. Nowhere near. So Part back. One for double two.
Seen these missed. Took a one set away from the title. One fat one. And right on the bottom for double two.
Yeah!
Easy peasy. Part one set away from this title, possibly.
Ninth set, first leg.
Yes, terrific Part there, getting that double two. And the one double two is the one that we pub players are not very fond of. We tend to miss the one anyway sometimes. But that was cool stuff from the Canadian. 5-3 up then, and looking good, wanting one more set. How he'd like it to be this one.
Lovely, lovely last dart there. To recap, Barney, in a fantastic match last night, beat Taylor. There were 23 maximums in that. I say again, 23. We've only had 16 in this, but there could be a while to go, folks. But John Part, atavistic player. Plays from the gut. Beautiful stylist, brilliant counter. Favourite at the moment, Johnny.
96.
Absolutely. Part, the fact is that Barneveld has to win every single set. The one saving grace is that he has the darts in two of those sets. Obviously, this is one of them. He will know that if he holds his throw, he's really got to give his all in the next set if he wins this one, Sid, when Part has the throw. It isn't over yet by a long chalk. We know that both of these players are scrappers. They were both two sets down in their semi-final encounters and came back to be on the stage today.
And also, echoing that point, Barney played, what, three, four games in the last day at Bolton and never flickered, just seemed to get better.
...54 left. Well, that makes double 18, 98. Nothing wrong with that. Barneveld will be looking to take this 76. Out.
2 8s coming in. All the bed here, Matt. Didn't need all the bed, just the middle!
Well, second leg is Jones. Peel double 8s off like nobody's business in practice. In match circumstances, when your third dart is for double 8 and the other fella's sitting on his favourite double, the pressure's on, but Barneveld was equal to it.
57.
If you're just coming in your house, Phil Tiller sitting out down there in a casual shirt, watching this lot after Barney did for him last night 55. In a classic. Pensive. Picking up, I'll bet picking up every nuance of both of these two. Because they're his big rivals now, folks.
Yeah, quietly enjoying it, Sid, I think. But still wishing that he was up there instead. Why not? That's the competitive edge in the man and so many players in this tournament.
The power watches. Darth Maple. Oh, clatters, there's 60.
140.
Barney's slapping the dart. Remember when he blew it against Tiller in the big challenge 7 years ago, John? He started slapping the dart. He mustn't, that can only be a negative factor.
140.
Now is really motoring, isn't he? It's like I said before, they have virtually identical now.
121. Johnny requires 69.
15 dot and early there, John.
Yes, but 16 will do. 17, even an 18 dart will be happy with because he knows he'll be back. And Barney's starting to shake his head 40. Now.
John, they weren't like me in Holland 32. For saying this, but once Taylor got five legs ahead and the head ahead for £100,000, Barney went to bits. Two hits for Part. He's Rocky John.
16.
Well, double 8's been very kind to both players, particularly Part in this match. But and he will be back for it. But that's 45 scored, 140 left, 90 left.
95.
Surely can't waste 16. Three darts here at double eight. Surely not.
Game on the second leg. Jump up.
Very silly of Barney to start slapping the dart. That means you just fling the dart without pointing it. Seen him do it before.
140.
Barney knows that he's got a win on his throw. No problem. It doesn't matter how poorly he throws when John Part is throwing first. He's got to throw well on his own throw. Stay in the match by winning 100. The set. It might mean that he indulges in brinkmanship, the set going all the way. But he's got to hold his throw.
81.
Only 81. Turn 40 makes life very interesting now by Party. This is the big dance, folks. 60. This is the last waltz. This is the final here in the desert.
Unlucky 60. Does it let Part in? Not really. 121 behind. Ton 80 would be very handy. There's the one anyway. He's got rid of the odd one.
81.
10 180s to John Part. 6 to Barney. Last night he had 13 against Tiller. Do the math.
27.
Yes, in legs, 38 legs played in this match. Part 21. Barneveld 17. Percentage has gone down a touch. Part 42%, Barneveld 39% success rate.
Ah, it's 11th! He is on fire, his part! And I will tell you, it's taken a lot out of both these blokes.
65.
They are sweating cobs.
City into 180 not long ago, that didn't really matter. That one did. That was a brilliant 180, like one of Barnevelt's earlier. Now double five, is it going to be kind to him again? Yes, it did. Oh, now then, we're on the verge, possibly, of a John Part victory. He's won the leg against the throw, and now he's throwing for the title.
Came out with his match face on. A mask that will frighten the grizzly bear. Can do it with the next dozen or so darts.
But 68 is good news for Barnevelt. Can he find the treble? That's what happens when you're really, really trying too hard, Sid. That's what happens.
Only I've been saying that throughout this match. Barney was inspired against Taylor last night. He flowed. The flow is not there. We could talk forever about the psychology of playing against Bart rather than Taylor. But the flow has not been there for that Dutchman.
And let's give some credit for that to John Part. Perhaps he didn't expect his opponent to play quite as well as this. In the same way you'll remember at Plymouth, he was shocked by the way that Roland Scholten threw out of his skin, beyond even his best. And it shocked him. And I think there's an element of that in this, Sid.
That was an 11-3 win by Scholten. An absolute assassination by Scholten. So Part can now set up the push to that title with the next dart.
63.
Well, Part is on a three-dart finish, and what a finish it would be. Do you remember Colin Lloyd won the World Match Play at Blackpool last August with a 170 finish? Sid, can he do it as well?
260s in bowl, and Party can starty. Travel 18 Sandy, I go over the ball.
So, 116, it's a nice one for Barnevelt, this normally, because double 18, it's got to be kind to him this time, it isn't again. Let him down again.
Just pulled it. For the Desert Classic title, John Part of Canada. Seven. Double four, will do.
Oh, yes, John Part is the Desert Classic 5 champion. He has been fantastic coming back from a set down to beat Raymond van Barneveld 6-3.
Commentating is a hard job. I thought it would be the other way round, but Johnny Part has beaten Taylor's conqueror, and isn't he chuffed?
And why not? A brilliant match, yes. It was Barnevelt who threw better in the early stages, went to set up, but John Part hit back with three sets in a row. It was the vital fifth that saw Barney bite back, but Part made it 3-all, 4-3, 5-3 and 6-3, and he's the champion.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you now please welcome on stage our presentation party, Mr. Chris Bordesan, the Vice President of Entertainment for the Mandalay Bay, and the chairman of the PDC, Mr. Barry Hearn. Ladies and gentlemen, a fantastic final. Would you please salute the runner-up, Mr. Raymond van Barneveld. And ladies and gentlemen, your partypoker.net Las Vegas Desert Classic champion from Canada, Mr. John Part.
John, congratulations. What a match and what a week you've had.
Well, thank you. First of all, thank you, everyone. I've had so much support this week, and maybe times I wasn't quite myself, and I still I found resources, but I had a lot of help finding those resources, all the support I had here, and I want to thank everyone, all the support, so much. Thank you.
You've been in a final here before. You've beaten Taylor here before. You must feel a little bit for Raymond and what he's been through this week as well.
Well, I did exactly the same thing a few years ago, and I guess comes around, goes around, so I think I got mine now. I don't feel too sorry for Raymond, UK Open champion here.
Raymond, commiserations, but it's been a memorable week for you.
Want to swap pens, John? No.
Put it in the back pocket for you.
No, I think I played my worst game this week. I played well in the qualifications. I did well against all three matches. But today, it went in. That double 18, normally one dart or two darts. But tonight, it was John's game. All respect to John. I like him a lot. He's a fantastic player. And I'm cheering him on in about 2 weeks. Match play, John.
Huh? Thank you, yeah.
I come over, play the Bobby Bummer, and stay a few days to get this man along, maybe the trophy there. Huh?
Well, maybe. That's a lot of maybes right there, but I'd have to say that I had a terrific honor in 2003 being a world champion, beating Phil Taylor. And I didn't think there was anything maybe near that could follow it up, but to be a champion here in Vegas, beating four-time world champion Raymond Barneveld, sure comes close, if not as good. Thank you.
Was there ever a time, John, when you thought, you know, another major title, another major televised title might not come, because like you say, 2003 was the last time we saw you winning, although you've made a lot of finals?
I've just always believed in myself, no matter how poorly I perform or no matter how well someone performs against me, I just keep going forward. And my motto this week, I spoke to Russ Ray about this, is I switched from being consistent to being persistent. And that worked. I'm the most persistent dart player this week.
Ladies and gentlemen, the partypoker.net Vegas Desert Classic champion, John Part. And of course, we're back with more darts. Blackpool is the next stop on our darts roadshow. Sunday, the 23rd of July, 7:30, Sky Sports 1. The World Match Play Championship. Will John Part reach another final? So thank you for joining us. It's been a fantastic week of darts here in Vegas. John Part, his career certainly taking off once again. Goodbye.
More movie fight scenes kick off here, first. More movie car chases burn rubber here, first. More movie punchlines are delivered here, first. 9 out of 10 top UK box office films have their first UK TV showing on Sky Movies. And we've got more HD movie screens than anyone in the UK. Make Sky Movies your first stop in movies entertainment.
Say hello to the new dairy-free, caffeine-free, coffee-free Slappuccino.
Strongbow, taste that hits a little deeper.
Being in debt put me under such pressure. It felt like getting another loan was the only way of giving myself some breathing space and relieving some of the tension. But I knew that wasn't the answer, because then I'd just be in more debt. I was already struggling with repayments, and demands came through my letterbox almost every day. So getting another loan just wasn't an option. I felt lost and helpless. It just felt like I was never going to get myself free from debt. But that was all before I took control and contacted Debt Matters. They offered me support and they understood my situation. By using government legislation, they were able to freeze the interest on my debts. They could even reduce the actual amount you owe by up to 75%. Debt Matters are only a phone call away, and they helped me get out of the red and into the black.
Call Debt Matters free on 08000 55 66 77 or text DEBT to 88800.
I'm here to find out more about loans. Lots of people have money outstanding on credit cards and loans, and they haven't stopped to think just how much they're paying every month. Loans.co.uk could consolidate all your credit into one easy loan and save you a lot of money overall. This customer is now paying over £300 less per month, could save over £5,000 in interest, paying it off in half the time. And there's nothing to repay for the first 5 months.
Excuse me, Phil.
Sorry, mate. It's worth talking to the experts.
If you're a homeowner and you need a loan, call loans.co.uk on 0800 856 7031.
New Ceres from Strongbow. Taste that hits a little deeper.
Coming up, live cricket, Northants, Worcestershire today at 5:30 on Sky Sports 1. Surrey Sussex